line to the British throne. Please count with those fingers. Is it A, Princess Eugenie, B, Zara Phillips, or C?
The planet is being destroyed all around us. Using money to try to address that problem, it's shooting yourself in the foot. Evolve or perish, grow up or die. An entirely new level of human consciousness is needed right now. 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 Or we're all dead.
The idea of survival of the fittest is one that does not involve competition by its nature at all. It merely suggests that creatures that adapt best to a changing environment are around to live and reproduce another day, another day, another day.
The entire money-structured and materialistic-oriented society is a false society. False society.
That's a very simple notion of what a society is. It's supposed to be this system that's there to support everyone.
We are creating an underclass. We are exploiting poor people all over the world.
We live in a monetary paradigm that demands infinite growth, so balance is not possible. Not possible. Not possible.
Profit is a filthy word.
And here we sit with the world still burning oil and gas and coal when we have had all the information we need to have had a completely new civilization.
The more conflict, problems, pollution, and scarcity there is, the more money there is to be made and the more jobs there are to be created.
Profit is a filthy word.
You are operating on a tiny, tiny fraction of your infinite possibility.
We have the brains, the know-how, the technology, and the feasibility to build an entirely new civilization.
There are 10 calories of hydrocarbon energy in every calorie of food consumed in the industrialized world.
Profit is a filthy word.
There are 7.1 billion people on the world today. There were only 1 billion people on the world when man discovered oil. And all populations, once they hit that unfettered growth, they all have a collapse. They all dive and die off.
And so the economic system is set up to ensure 80% of the world is in poverty.
We can get enough power to electrify the world.
We've been living off of fossil deposits, which is one of the most ignorant things possible since we're surrounded by the movement of energy from the sun and everything else.
Profit is a filthy word, because wherever there is profit, there is also deficit.
This, according to Oxfam, of the world's 85 richest people is equal to the 3.5 billion poorest people.
It's fantastic. And this is a great thing because it inspires everybody, gets the motivation to look up to the 1% and say, I want to become one of those people. I want to become one of those people.
If you want to manipulate and suppress and enslave billions of people, you cannot have them in expanded conscious awareness.
Why are we going to continue to contribute to this facade?
We feel an educated population needs no control.
75% of the global workforce could be replaced by mechanization tomorrow.
Phase out human drivers, put electronic guidance systems in cars.
As long as the task involved only mechanical skill, the higher the pay, the better the performance. Once the task called for even rudimentary cognitive skill, a larger reward led to poorer performance. Poorer performance. Poorer performance.
The bottom line is that the labor for income game is slowly coming to an end.
The environment will be transformed. We will have a new macroeconomic system. The work week for the average person will fall to about 15 to 20 hours a week.
Capitalism, socialism, and communism are all terms that need to be tossed in the trash can immediately because all of them were created on the assumption of infinite resources.
You have to put them in a tiny bubble of reality that sees themselves as little me, I have no power.
This is enough now. Stop voting, stop pretending, wake up. Be in reality.
oil prices spike again,
and nobody can afford to buy that oil. And everything will just shut down, shut down.
We can get enough power to electrify the world.
It is the biggest change in the history of the human race.
The Justin Bieber mugshots are in, and they're incredible.
There's no crisis in energy. There's no energy problem. There's only the crisis of ignorance. We have plenty of energy.
What you want to have is a change to a new paradigm, getting the old one out of the way, while there's still infrastructure left to start building something new.
These people, I so pity you guys trapped in the system, trying to keep everybody else trapped in the bucket system. I pity your level of misery.
We live in a very fucked up, sick culture. We really do. The society is mentally ill. To be normal is to be messed up.
The love of money is the root of all evil, and it is the love of money which has the potential to exterminate, to render extinct the entire human race.
We are all collectively responsible for what may be the greatest preventable holocaust in the history of planet Earth.